This is a 2020 Hyundai Ioniq Electric with the 38 kilowatt hour battery, and I've got to do a trip today, so I'm going to do a video about the efficiency of these cars. So let's unplug it. It was on charge overnight on cheap rate electricity, so it should be fully charged. Turn that radio off. So, as you can see there, the battery is fully charged. It's got a predicted range of 204 miles, but I'm going to be doing motorway driving, so there's no way we're going to get that. So I'm going to drive down to Cobham services on the M25. So I'm in Oxfordshire, so it's A34, M4, M25 and back. So it's about a 3-hour journey. And this journey is motorway, door-to-door, well, motorway and dual carriageway. And that's where EVs are at their least efficient. It's inefficient driving, driving at speed, of course, just like a combustion engine vehicle. However, with a combustion engine vehicle, their sort of most economical driving is at sort of 50 miles an hour or so. They don't like stop-start driving. It's completely opposite with an electric vehicle. Electric vehicles are very efficient with sort of urban driving. They're not so efficient with motorway driving, and that's because you're driving at speed all the time and the air causes a lot of resistance. So the faster you drive, the more fuel you're going to use, in this case electricity. But also there's no junctions, corners, roundabouts, traffic lights to slow down for. Of course, a motorway, there's none of those, so you're going at speed all the time, and therefore you're not getting any regen braking back. So with an EV, every time you slow down for those junctions and corners, when you're slowing down, the motor turns into a dynamo and is producing electricity and puts it back into your battery pack. So all the slowing down, you're capturing that kinetic energy going forward and putting it back into the battery pack, which extends your range. That improves your driving efficiency. So that's why motorway driving is the least efficient, just because you're not getting any regen back. And of course, you're driving at speed through that thick air, as it were. So this is a 3-hour journey, as I said. So I'm going to measure the efficiency. Recently I've been getting 4.6 miles per kilowatt hour just driving around locally. And actually we can see that on here. Still not particularly familiar with this car. So we can go to energy information and history. And we can see there recent driving, 45 miles. When was that? 2 days ago. 5.1, 5, 4.9, 5.9, 5.3. And I don't try to drive efficiently because I don't need to. As you can see, most of the driving is sort of local. Apart from then, 209 miles that day, 5.3. I have a feeling that was when my father was driving it. We picked a vehicle up. So he was driving a lot more efficient than I would. But anyway, let's get out my way and see what this car gets after 3 hours of motorway driving. So this trip is only 75 miles each way or so, which doesn't sound very far, but that's why I prefer to talk about hours, and it's a 3-hour drive, because most people think they drive much further than they actually do. So when people are looking at an EV, many people will say, well, I'm not going to get an EV until it does the same as my combustion engine vehicle, that sort of 400, 500 mile range. But of course, most of us just don't need a car that does that many range. And you'll find with their combustion engine vehicle, they're probably filling the tank every 2 weeks or so. But with an electric vehicle, if you can charge from home, you're filling it every day. So you start every day with a full battery pack. And the UK average is actually only 20 to 25 miles a day. So of course, any EV can do many days of driving very comfortably without any hassle at all. So a trip like this, while to many people it doesn't sound a very good test, it's actually way more than people do drive in the UK. However, I'm not doing a range test today, I'm measuring the efficiency at motorway driving. But of course, range is the result of the efficiency of the vehicle. So the more efficient the vehicle is, the more range you're going to get. And these Ioniqs are probably the most efficient electric vehicle out there on the UK roads, and they do have smaller batteries than most, but because they're so efficient, they'll actually get a much better range than a lot of other cars with a much larger battery. So I'm going to be driving at 70 miles an hour. I'm going to keep dead on the speed limit all the time. I'm not going to be trying to drive this efficiently, as it were. I'm in normal drive mode, not in eco mode. I'm going to keep up with all the traffic. But it is quiet today. It is a Sunday morning, and normally I do this trip on a Sunday evening, and the M25 is usually busy on a Sunday, but by the looks of it, it's all going to be quiet and free-flowing, so driving at full speed, as it were. Well, the UK speed limit all the way. So I got to Cobham Services, our meeting point this morning, and the M25 was still as busy as normal, so it still took 1.5 hours. Anyway, at Cobham Services, if you don't know, there's 6 Ioniq chargers here, and they're all busy, and there's a line of EVs parked up there waiting. There's another one there, I'm not sure whether they're waiting, but yeah, it's very busy here this morning. And then over here, there are 3 grid serve chargers, all in use, but it's looking less busy in this side of the car park. But I don't need to charge, I've got more than enough to get me home and last a few days. So I'm going to get back on the M25 shortly. So I've just got back, it's now 1 p.m. so driving in the UK just takes such a long time. So while I haven't driven many miles, it has been 3 hours of driving. So let's have a look here. So I've got back, the battery is at 37%, 76 miles of range still left in the vehicle, and energy information, I don't think I'm going to see today's stats here. No, I'm not, because this is per day, so I'm not going to see today's stats until tomorrow. But I did remember to reset the meter up here. So let me just see driving information. So where is it there? Is that today's? I'm getting a bit confused here. Let's just have a look. So no, this is today's. 127 miles. I averaged 5.4 miles per kilowatt hour and 3 hours and 1 minute of driving. So 5.4 miles per kilowatt hour over a 3 hour drive, and that was all on dual carriageways and motorways. So most of it was at 70 miles an hour. All the time I was doing the maximum speed limit, or the speed that the road or traffic would allow. So there are a few sections where it's 50 miles an hour. I did sort of go A34, M4, cut across Bagshot Way to get on the M3, and then up the M3 to the M25, because that was the quickest route. And obviously that M3 to M25 section, I know it's only 6 miles or so, but that's all 50. and it was a little bit stop-start in places on the M25, and with a contraflow, roadworks up near Cobham services, that was all at 50 as well. But I was driving maximum speed I could, all the speed limit, for 3 hours, and that's the average economy, 5.4 miles per kilowatt hour in a Hyundai Ioniq. So what this has highlighted is just how incredible these Ioniqs are, how efficient they are compared to other EVs. Because even driving at motorway speeds, I've averaged 5.4 miles per kilowatt hour. I'm not getting any worse efficiency than I am just driving around locally. And at this economy, the 38 kilowatt hour battery would give a range of 205 miles. But if you're driving on more economical roads, obviously driving more efficiently, as you can see, 5.9 there. But in the summer, it's quite easy to get 6 to 6.5 miles per kilowatt hour. But if you want to put more effort into it and drive more economically, maybe in eco mode and maybe with the air conditioning turned off, then you can get even better efficiencies out of these. So I think that's about it. If you want to know more about the Hyundai Ioniq Electric, I've done loads of videos on these cars and also the previous generation with the 28 kilowatt hour battery. So in the video description below is a link to a playlist where you can see other videos on these cars. So if you found this video useful, please do click the thumbs up button. That really does help. Also subscribe to the channel to learn more about EVs. And that's it. I'll see you on the next video.